Good evening, I'm Juhi Rajput and you're watching Empowering India, a TV program which showcases the contribution of central and state government companies in the socio-economic and infrastructure development of the nation. Today we'll talk about Uttarakhand, the 27th state of India, created on 9th November 2000 as the 10th Himalayan state of the country. Uttarakhand is blessed with the natural and mineral resources in abundance, especially water and forests with many glaciers, rivers, dense forests and snow-clad mountain peaks.
Uttarakhand is one of the few states in India which not only have high hydro potential of around 20,000 megawatt, but also have higher per capita consumption than the national average of 1,000 kilowatt. Uttarakhand is offering one of the lowest tariffs in the country for almost all categories of consumers.
We were rated as a C+ distribution company. And now last year in the ratings which are released by Ministry of Power, we are at A+ in line with the Gujarat distribution companies. So we have done a host of reforms. So whether it is the multi-year tariff or whether it is ACS ARR gap. So we are focusing on all of them, and largely 80 to 90% we have actualized all the reforms actually.
Uttarakhand has emerged as a significant destination for investments in manufacturing industry, tourism and infrastructure. Emphasis is on stimulating all the sector of its economy to grow to their fullest potential in keeping with the geographic profile of the state. Since power is the most crucial component of economic development, state government is striving to provide cost-effective, good-quality 24/7 power supply at competitive rates to all the consumers of the state of Uttarakhand.
We are rating all our divisions on a SEFI-SEDI, which is the Power Reliability Index, how many times the power goes and for what duration. We are rating our divisions on a daily basis, and I review that every day. Whether it is village electrification target, revenue realization target, or the SEFI-SEDI target as a part of the annual appraisal of all the officers. So these targets get into the annual appraisal. We've already approved and it's in place now for us. So this is an institutional reform where we will make every employee in all our power sector organizations accountable for better service delivery.
Uttarakhand is third state in the country selected for 24/7 Power for All program. This program is being implemented by Government of Uttarakhand with active support from Government of India with the objective of connecting the unconnected in phased manner by financial year 2018, ensuring 24/7 quality, reliable and affordable power supply to all domestic, commercial, agriculture and industrial consumers within a fixed time frame.
In order to meet the increasing demand, the state has already planned additional capacity availability of 1,035 megawatt through own generating stations, renewable energy sources and central generating stations in a phased manner by the year 2019. Also, the AT&C losses, which were in tune of 29.41% in 2010, have reduced to 16.42% in the financial year 2016-17. The state has undertaken a number of steps such as defective meter replacement, rates for checking thefts, replacement of mechanical meters, metering of unmetered connections, etc.
Government of Uttarakhand has proposed an aggressive trajectory for T&D loss reduction. State DISCOM plans to reduce the losses up to 14% by financial year 2019 with the help of existing measures as well as initiatives being taken under RAPDRP and new initiatives planned under IPDS.
I am delighted to share that our AT&C target, which was there in Uday, we have almost already achieved it. So we are at around 15.85% today in terms of AT&C losses. And our continuous efforts are to bring it even down. So we are monitoring all the targets which were there as a part of our Uday MOU. And we are sure that maybe in the next 3 to 5 years, we'll excel on all those operational parameters.
The state government has taken several measures to curb power theft, including setting up of the strengthened vigilance and raids organization in the DISCOM with police enforcement to curb inter and intra-corrupt practices in respect of electricity theft.
We've also focused largely on power theft. We've also done a lot of efforts to reduce our AT&C losses further, though we are on an average, we are particularly good, but we have regional disparities. So some places AT&C is fine, but at some places it is huge, especially in the plain districts. So what we've done in the last 6 months is we've done around more than 1,700 raids to actually curb this. We've lodged around 1,400 plus FIRs, and a lot of revenue has been realized in the process. And we have created this entire atmosphere where whether it is, anyone who is involved in this is actually scared because we are doing it on a random basis.
Here we'll take a short break. There's a lot more on the other side. Stay tuned.